The Edge, hi. Hey, I've got to ask about your iconic nickname. Where did it come from?
You know, when we were 15 and 16 year olds, we just had this culture of nickname giving. And generally speaking, it was it would be a slag. It would be which is an Irish term for a sort of good-natured ribbing or whatever. So the Edge, it was about my chin.
Oh.
That's apparently, I had a sort of strong chin, and that's what they picked up on.
And then there was that time that you actually didn't see the Edge and you fell off the stage in Vancouver. A similar thing happened to Chris Martin from Coldplay here just recently. How scary is it when something like that happens?
You know, I was so lucky because it was the opening night of the tour, so we weren't really that familiar with the staging, and I just cut the corner and literally walked straight off the stage. But what I missed as I hit the ground was these big spikes, which were the dolly track for one of the cameras, by literally inches. Had I landed on one, that would have been the end of me and the tour. But I literally was completely unscathed. So for whatever reason, got super lucky and was able to just stand up, wave to the crowd, and feeling a little silly, walk out.
Now they're celebrating 20 years of the iconic album How to Dismantle an Atomic Bomb, releasing a remastered version with never-before-heard songs to add to the classics.
Was there anything that surprised you revisiting these songs 20 years on?
I was surprised by the fact that the themes and the songs have remained quite fresh. I feel myself, when things get really rough, but politically around the world, that's when music and art and movies kind of has to fill some kind of a void and try and help us deal with what's going on.
And the new songs that you've dug up, straight from the vault, I mean, they are brilliant. How did they end up on the cutting room floor the first time round?
We were spoilt for choice of that end phase of the album, and we didn't get them finished in time to be considered. But it's funny, we played the mixes to Noel Gallagher during the summer.
Oh.
And his comment was, I want my money back. I bought that album when it came out, believing that they were the best songs you had. And now look, you've been holding out on us. And it's true, they could for sure have made the album.
Now, is it true that if it wasn't for you noodling around on a prototype guitar, that we may never have heard With or Without You on the radio?
What happened is Bono was in one room and they were deconstructing the song. And I was in the other room with this new thing called the Infinite Guitar, which was a prototype. And they were like, what is that? So Bono came in and says, what's that? I said, oh, I'm just playing this Infinite Guitar thing. He says, it's brilliant. Come in. So I just went in and I played over the bass, and that was the sort of the magic inspiration. And that's the key thing, is being alive to little incidents like that and hearing it and going, that is important. That accident, we're going to keep that.
A beautiful accident. You and Bono, you are one of the great music partnerships. But music really is an industry that can tear relationships apart, a bit like the Gallagher brothers, even. What is it that's kept you together for all these years?
I think we complement each other is the most important thing. Like, I know deep down that, you know, my best work is done in partnership with Bono, particularly, but Adam and Larry as well. The music is always the boss. That's kind of our motto. So if we ever fall out or have a big row about a tune, it's generally because it's not right. It's not there. It's funny, when something arrives, when it really has reached its best form, it's like arguments stop. But also we started out as friends and figured out any sort of differences or tensions and rivalries before we really became a big band. We would just be hanging out together, even in, you know, these highfalutin Hollywood parties. At the end of the night, we'd be in a corner chatting because we genuinely like being around each other. You know, we're actually, we are friends.
Whoa. Wow. Good, Sarah.
vocal and so lovely as well, you know. It's such a cracker of an album, especially if you're a fan. Some of those songs that have been dug out of the vault are incredible. A couple of remixes as well. The 20th anniversary edition of How to Dismantle an Atomic Bomb is out now.